I'd like to welcome everybody to the April 21st meeting of the Finance Committee here in South Deerfield, Massachusetts at 6:30, and we got five of us here tonight. I think that's going to be the full slate, and Doug unfortunately won't be here tonight, but I think we'll be able to make do. We've through the hard work of the committee, we got a lot of stuff done the last few meetings, and we do have some cleanup items, but I think a lot of the heavy lifting had been done, and we'll be in a pretty good spot to go and, you know, present our thoughts next week at town meeting and to the voters, and everybody can kind of decide what they want to do on any issues that do come up and people have questions about. So the first thing I'd like to do, as we usually do, is to look to approve the minutes. I did send them around electronically, but here's a copy. And I will, I think that's all I got.
That's
okay. The one thing I noticed actually after I printed them out is a number three. That budget was actually interest on maturing debt. I had typed interest on temporary loans, but so the budget number's right, all the information's right, but it should say maturing debt, so I'll make that change when I file it. And I'll give you guys just a couple minutes to skim through it. These aren't as long as last week's, so, or the last meetings. Should play some hold music for everyone watching while we do this.
Just on four with the Frontier budget at the very end, as far as the vote, there's one that abstained. I don't know if that makes a difference.
Oh, no, it does, but... Oh, wow, I thought I had that.
Which one is that?
On
right.
Four.
Yep. No, you're totally right. I'm sorry.
Yep.
Good
nope.
Catch.
That's okay.
Passed 4-0. Oops. 4-0-1.
Correct.
Because then the... Oh, you know what I think it was? Because then the SCEM's indirect cost number, that passed unanimously.
Correct.
And then the next one was again 4-0-1 for the wastewater treatment. So
correct.
That's what happened. Okay.
Yep.
I must have switched the order and not switched the...
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, did you talk to Doug about the headworks? Was Kevin going to...
I do, I have.
I've got feedback?
Yep, okay. I think we're in a good spot to kind of resolve and answer all the things we had outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
We have to vote on this?
Yeah, so if anyone, unless, or I think Ralph's still giving it a look, actually. Sorry, and thank you, Mary, for getting them, turning them around since we met 2 days ago, so appreciate that.
You certainly do clean them up nicely.
As far as everybody else knows, they come to me like this. Just take it. I guess it'll be next year we'll find out, right?
Mm. Next year may not have me as a partner.
Oh, okay.
No, you'll be chair, right?
No.
Hey, you'll be doing the cleanup
right.
Now. You know
there
how
you
it's
go.
Done.
I'm easing out of this stuff. Is that your supper?
What, the cookies? I brought them for anybody. I thought this would be a little bit shorter and lighter of a meeting. Would you like one?
I'm going to take one.
Oatmeal.
Would you like a cookie?
No, thank you.
You should have a cookie.
I'm going to have one, certainly.
Share cookies again.
At least I can do.
I thought that was your supper.
Oh, at least it's...
No, that's okay.
Well, it's good to check the details.
So.
Yeah.
Any other comments? All right, so then we'll be revising the item number three to interesting and maturing debt, and then flip-flopping the vote results. The results are the same, but the description of unanimous and 4-0-1 on items 4 and 5.
Yeah.
So I'll make those changes, and if anyone wants to make a motion to recommend that amended minutes.
I'll make that.
Thank you.
Motion. I'll second it.
Thanks, guys. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Okay. Minutes have been passed. I'll send those back around. The second item we have is a request for a reserve fund transfer. And I'll just read this out. So the amount requested is $450 from the Zoning Board of Appeals. They have overspent a line item related to postage and miscellaneous expenses for FY16. And the reason is that the certified mail sent out in relation to ZBA matters is reimbursable, but the reimbursements come into the general fund. Oh. So mm-hmm. when they do more, mm-hmm. it's not actually costing the town more, but we need to set more over here, and then more comes back the other place. So that's the long and short of that. Mm-hmm. Anybody have any questions or concerns on that one?
No.
No.
Okay. Anyone like to make a motion to recommend the 450 transfer?
I'll make the motion.
All right, thanks.
I'll second that.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so let's see. Meeting. Let me just fill this. I'll fill this out after. Leave it for Doug. Okay. So we got a few cleanup items. The first one is from the special town meeting warrant. We got two from that. Article 3 was the energy loan. And it's funny because this had come up a few times, but it does turn out that the amount is being lowered that we have to pay off. The reason is that there was still a principal payment in FY16 to be made sometime in the next month or two.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So the $18,000 per year principal we've been paying, we hadn't yet paid it yet. So when we do, then what's left will instead of be $275,000 will be $257,200.
Yep.
So
right. Good.
It's $257,200. Yeah. So I guess just I don't think it changes anything because we voted more than that, but I'd like to remake a motion to pay off in full the amount of $257,200 on the energy loan from free cash. Anyone like to second that?
Yep.
Sure. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Okay, great. The other one from the special town meeting warrant is Article 6. This was one that we took no action. Well, we voted to recommend and it failed, if I remember correctly, but this is the one about the sewer change to the sewer bylaws, and I've been instructed by Doug that the select board will be looking to take no action on this mm-hmm. At town meeting. So nothing we have mm-hmm. to do, but just letting you guys know that and whoever's watching
so
as well.
So what was behind that? I still didn't quite get a clear feeling.
Well, let me hold on that, okay. And after I answer the next topic, we'll okay. come back to that question. Because the next thing to bring up, there's no votes needed on that one, is regular town meeting warrant, item number 10, the wastewater treatment plant, the Headworks project. So this was the one that we had initially voted to recommend the $130,000 for the engineering.
Yep.
And then we noticed that there was language about a project itself, which didn't have a lot of details. Since Tuesday, Kevin, in coordination with Doug and others, has decided to hold off on that and make this motion simply and solely about the engineering work and the $130,000.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know how they'll do that, if they will have amended language put before town meeting. I'm going to just leave it as we've done it. We voted that specific component.
Yep.
We did vote not to do the broader project described in this version of the motion, but as I don't have revised language, I don't think we need to vote again. We'll just leave it at that. It's certainly what's intended. So I think to your question, and I wasn't part of these conversations, but it seems that there's been a bit of a slowing down of this process. We're still going in the direction of investing in the wastewater treatment plant and thinking about long-term solutions to problems we face. But for this town meeting, it seems that we're prioritizing additional investments through the expense line items and the engineering work to lay out the plan for the Headworks project and not going forward with the project itself or the change to the funding formula of how project can get funded. So
that was mm-hmm. a good lesson.
Yeah, I think, Yeah, because Kevin stopped to see me today and just kind of let me know, so I'd have the information, and I appreciate him doing that.
Sky wasn't falling.
Those guys thinking about it. Well, I still think it's an important project, but I don't think it's worth having a process that... The process being as it was on that project made people not want to change the language of the funding because they want to make sure that it's going to be a well-thought-out and well-planned project, and I think it will be, and I think Kevin will do a great job of making that happen, and so I think this will work out better in the end for everyone. Okay, moving along, regular town meeting warrant article number 11, South County EMS budget. I wanted to bring this up really quick, nothing to vote, but... If we remember, there was the article on the FY16 indirect costs that we recommended, and there were some questions about calculations. So just to update everybody, when we went through and looked at how you would calculate the FY17 indirect cost number, it's different and higher than what is in their budget or what they paid last year. And as an example of one thing that doesn't make sense, the fact that the PEG access money is going into a certain pocket is in the formula, so that increases their cost, which doesn't really make a lot of sense. So Doug and I went back and forth, and you know, I think that there may need to be a modified or more simplified approach to the formula itself. I know the first time around it took a year, and we seem to have used it once and now may have to find something else, but I do think that, you know, and again, it's not about the difference in money. It's about, you know, once you start excluding this and adding that, excluding this, it's more trouble than it's worth. So I just want to bring that up where I don't anticipate, you know, the budget is the budget, and whatever the cost they bill out will be the cost they bill out. But I just wanted to bring it up because it did come up. Doing a lot of talking tonight. All right. The next one is, and this is the other one we have to vote tonight, the CPA projects. So this is article number 13 from... the regular annual town meeting warrant. So I spoke with Dan Graves, who was very helpful on these projects. There are two projects that were submitted this year, and they're both recommended. One is the Civil War statue that they were doing work to in Old Deerfield to build a case and have it displayed, I believe, here, but I'm not sure if that's finalized. Cost is around $5,000. Dan said they looked into it. It fit within the criteria of the money it's coming out of, and they were supportive of it, and so am I. The other project is $20,000 of CPA money towards gravestone restoration at Albany Road Cemetery. This is part of ongoing restoration projects they look to do to various cemeteries around town. There is also some money being put up by, I think, Deerfield Academy and maybe even another source as well towards it on top of that money. So, you know, this is a concerted effort. It's something we've been doing and going to continue to do. And again, Dan supported that effort, and so do I.
I think that's a good thing. I know the work that was done on the little cemetery over here by Fisher's Garage, really well done, and it needed it bad, but I'm aware of that one up there, and that's even in worse condition. And it's really part of the original history of this town, and I think it's worth it to preserve it.
I agree. The one other comment I'd make on the CPA, we had a question about the administrative costs. So they have the ability to set aside up to 5% of the annual revenues as administrative costs. He verified to me, Dan did, that whatever is unspent just goes back into the general CPA pot, not the general fund of the town, but the CPA for the next year to be redeployed. However, and he sent me the last few years of administrative expenditures, which were pretty small. It was mostly some dues and a couple other things here and there, using maybe $1,000 a year. So, you know, they put it in because they can, it rolls back when they don't use it, and they've been pretty judicious about it. So
it gives them the flexibility if something comes along.
Right. So, so my overall take on this is I think, you know, these guys continue to do a good job of their part of the process, and so I'm supportive of their recommendations. So I'll make a motion to recommend Article 13 on the annual town meeting warrant related to the CPA projects.
Second that.
Thanks. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. And I have one more, just informationally. On town meeting warrant, article number 25 is related to South County EMS and a proposed change to the intermunicipal agreement. The Select Board, or Doug has informed me, the Select Board will be requesting that no action is taken on this item at town meeting floor. We had not voted on this, and I wasn't planning to anyway, but just so.
It's too open-ended.
Well, you know, like I said, if more conversation wants to be had, that's yep. fine at town meeting, but it seems it'll be passed over, so
okay.
It seems moot at this point in time. And I don't even know the genesis of the decision, right. Just that it was made. So that is it for
what we need.
Budget line items and both warrants. That's all I got. Does anybody else have anything? The next thing and the last thing I guess I want to do is talk about the overall budget. I've got a couple things to pass out that you guys may find helpful. Anybody else have anything that we think we missed or should have covered again or in terms of individual line items or articles?
I think we're good.
Okay. All right. So now we get to look at spreadsheets. And I'll apologize to people watching at home because we're going to be talking from numbers that you unfortunately don't have. I will look to attach these to our minutes. Here, Ralph, is one for you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So this is something that I put together, and if you guys would allow me to just kind of walk through it a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I found it very difficult to sort of parse through the information in the budget as it's there's just reams of paper.
Mm-hmm.
And so I tried to just simplify this thing and distill this down. So I'll start from the top. So the blue box at the top, this is basically, this is the revenue side,
right?
So we've got FY 15, 16, and 17, and then the changes between 16 and 17. So we can see right there that overall, the town is going to be spending, based on this budget, as requested, is raising $15.3 million. It's an increase of about $1.1 million, as Doug mentioned a couple days ago. And you can see the breakout of where those additional revenues are coming from. So, you know, the total property taxes are the straightforward, you know, 2.5% plus new growth plus excluded debt. You know, that's your number. The cherry sheet revenues were slightly higher. There's about 17,000 extra for Chapter 70. There's about 20,000 additional funds for unrestricted local aid. So there's some money there. The local receipts are quite a bit higher, 200,000 higher than the previous year. That is some increases in estimates, and then also the inspection and wiring revenues mm-hmm. are now in there, so that's a good chunk of that as well.
Mm-hmm.
The other funding sources line item, this is lower, so that was higher by 120,000 because of the usage of sewer reserves, but then reduced by quite a bit, 150,000 from last year. We used a lot of one-off accounts, ambulance reserve, overlay surplus, stuff that we shouldn't be using. So I think this is a huge step in the right direction mm-hmm. to get away from using non-persistent revenue
right.
sources
mm-hmm.
to fund the budget. So I'm glad that number's down. The other accounts total, the 58,000, that is primarily the municipal building reserve fund for the capital projects that are being paid out of that.
Mm-hmm.
So now that's another one that is not, there's an end to that as well. So, you know, at some point we won't have that. That will be exhausted.
Those things can mislead you.
Right. So sewer revenue is higher because the expense budget is higher. And then free cash is considerably higher. Now, to talk about the way we'd like to do budgets in the future, ideally, at the beginning of the year, we'd set all these numbers in you know, September, have free cash certified, and decide how much free cash we want to set aside, and then use an input of, okay, we've got 600,000 of free cash to spend. Now
mm-hmm.
we've got our revenues. Now we know how much we're spending.
Yep.
Now we can talk about how to allocate it between the different things we want to do. Unfortunately, as we know, what we do instead is build the expenses and then plug in a number for free cash so it balances.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
we can certainly do better, but I think we made some steps this year. And I put at the top right our certified free cash of $1.4 million. The usage of free cash based on this budget of $981,000, leaving us with a free cash based on these numbers, assuming all requested numbers were voted in,
yeah.
Of $436,000.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the revenue side of the equation. And now, if it makes sense to you guys, I'll kind of walk through quickly the expense. I have a few comments to make on those, and
sure.
then we can just open it up
yeah.
and discuss. So I broke out the omnibus uses. So the omnibus budget, as requested, is $13.475 million. That is an increase of about 3% from last year. So not a small number, but not a huge number.
Not
right?
too bad.
Right. Mm-hmm. And as you look at the percents for each of the individual line items, general government, public safety, and so on, you know, some of them increased by decent dollar amounts or percentages. So general government was up by 82,000, 10%. However, 77,000 of that is PEG access cost. Mm-hmm. So that honestly, that the general government line item is more or less unchanged from last year.
Right.
Public safety is up by 95,000, which is about 10% of that budget, and that is primarily the additional police officer requested and the additional hours for the building commissioner.
Right.
And as you can see to the right, I've noted differences with our recommended budgets in the green column. So, you know, for public safety, the 47,000 that were lower, that is the difference in the police budget. I think that's it. I'm not sure. Maybe there's some other small line item, but that's basically the difference. The one other thing I'd point out in this, in the omnibus budget, is employee benefits was a decrease of 67,000 from last year. And that's great, so long as we understand that will not persist.
Right. I was going to say, that's not normal.
There was a decent reduction in the retirement assessment, and there was a decent reduction in the unemployment insurance. If you remember, we had boosted that up last year because we had some layoffs and we didn't know.
Right.
And I don't know how the expenditures worked out, but either way, the budget for this year didn't have to be as high.
Right.
So that's kind of what I'd point out in that one. The next section are the warrant item uses, and you'll recognize all of these as things that we've voted on and talked about this year. The only thing I would point out, even though it's just so you understand what it is, the SCEMS budget, if you notice, there's a slightly different amount requested for FY17, that 314656, whereas we voted 314307. Mm-hmm. That difference was taking into account that indirect cost calculation thing that I was talking about with Doug. So I think that he and I have agreed that he's just going to keep it at 314307 because that was the budget they submitted. And, you know, then you'll have different budgets to different towns and a whole mess like we had last year. So that's why there's a $350 difference there. And then the bottom section, the capital uses, I would point out that I did not have the information for FY15 and 16. So I kind of, there's a couple numbers I saw and I just kind of threw stuff in there on an estimate, but those may not be accurate. 17 ones obviously are. And the only thing I'll point out is we had recommended a lower amount for the municipal reserve items, and that is in accordance with the Capital Improvement Committee's recommendations. If you remember, there were two things at the senior center they did not recommend, and we took their recommendation. So to kind of look at the bottom line here, if you look, the FY17 as requested actually lines up. It's great. It's 15,302,649, just like the revenue. So those actually match. We were able to tie out the budget. And then our recommended budget is 15,185,211. So it's $117,000 less, all told, with all the different line items as you pick them up. So I'll give you guys a minute to digest all of that, and then if there's any questions or comments, we can discuss it.
I like the way this is presented, though. It's easy to...
It's a lot better, right?
Yeah.
It's a lot easier, right? A lot easier to read.
Yeah, because all this information exists. It's just in a lot of different places.
Yeah.
And sorry if the font is a little small. I just want to keep it on one page.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I don't know why. It seems like I lost this free cash number through this process this year.
Lost what it was, what the certified was, or what?
All of a sudden, there was more.
Being used?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. Something about it changed.
If you recall, a few meetings ago, when we voted to split the revenue source on the energy loan, which we ended up not being able to do.
Right.
We did that because Doug's calculation at that point in time
was there wasn't.
Based on using free cash for the energy loan and based on the requested budgets, there was $300,000 in free cash at that time, which is what led us to try to use some from stabilization to get that up to $400,000.
Mm-hmm.
Now, some of the change since then was Doug had revised those budgets down, those four that we talked about.
Right.
And there's a couple other requested budgets, and I honestly think there's just a couple other formulas that got cleaned up, is what led to these numbers being better. But, you know, having now, you come for the cookies?
Sure.
Oh, okay. Well, we're sit down and give me 2 minutes. Let's wrap this little conversation up, and then we'll go over to you. I forget what I was saying, but so basically that's where the free cash, we got off a little bit in a tangent there, but I do feel pretty good about these numbers, and obviously if anything changes, we'll send that around.
This is much easier.
Ooh, we're going to mic you up. Sorry, I'm guessing I said something that required coming down. Oh, good.
Dark it.
Last time somebody walked in, we...
Yeah, usually when people come in, you know, in casual clothes, it's not...
They're getting phone calls.
Yeah.
Sort of a generalized thought here, but on the omnibus uses...
This is the oatmeal. You want that?
Yep. No,
that represents the running of the town.
I hope my wife's not watching.
Right.
And no, I can't.
Given the town the way it is, you know, I don't see that we're really growing or that there's... major things changing within the town. We even talked about the school is shrinking some. I guess I'm just trying to look ahead a few years. Are we kind of leveled off on costs other than just inflation, you think? I mean, are there some major surprises coming in that area that we're unaware of?
Well, that's obviously a big question.
Yeah, I know. It's
I guess I'd start by saying it's not entirely fair to say that just the omnibus budget are the cost of running the town.
No,
if you look
I know,
some of the warrant items, yeah. Like let's take a simple one, the reserve fund.
Yeah.
That's part of money you'll be used to do things that run the town for the most part.
Right.
So there's some things to be, you know, you could put in different buckets. As far as how you think about the projections over time, I think we did some very good work this year to reprioritize capital investment. Some things like highway expenditures and tree work, increasing those budgets from last year, starting to address wastewater treatment plants. I think that we're making some good decisions, but I still think there's some big projects out there.
Of course, I was kind of just looking at the omnibus use because, I mean, there always will be capital things that will come up, things will break or new needs come up, but the basic running of the town, the people, the numbers of people, don't you see the town is sort of stable now? I mean, do we expect our government to be growing?
Well, okay. I agree.
If you gather what I'm...
I agree with you in that the things that the town will do on a day-to-day basis to run probably are in a good place, but I think it's harder to know what the cost increases year over year of that are going to be. You know, like, let's just say, all right, well, inflation's at zero, but this number is not zero, and I don't think it is could be expected to be. So I still think that there's going to be a challenge if and as the increase in expenses is outpacing the increase in revenues or the acceptable revenues to the voters. You know, if revenues and expenses both go up by the same number and everybody's happy with that, it doesn't really matter what that number is. If they're in lockstep, then you're funding what you need, but it's when there's a mismatch.
Maybe I should say it differently. You're looking at the dollars.
Yeah.
I was looking at the numbers of department, the numbers of people in the department. Are we fairly well staffed for the size of our town, and do we expect some monumental growth to Deerfield? I mean, I don't see that happening.
That's a question for each department head. And, you know, I mean, we could talk to Kevin about what he sees, but, you know, and I think that's a good thing for us to spend some time on over the couple months after town meeting before kind of this term ends is stuff exactly like that. All right, let's think about 1, 3, 5 years down the line. How do we try to think about what we're going to be doing? And then we can start to think about how much that'll cost.
Yeah. I know it's not exactly numbers, but it eventually means numbers, you know.
No, you have a very good point, Ralph, and that's, I agree with Dylan, that's something that probably after town meeting we need to look at and ask those type of questions.
For example, if you went into some small town that's been lost in the woods and they have half the fire department that they should have and there's new safety demands that come in, they could be seeing a steamroller coming at them, you know. But it just seems as though this town is worked pretty hard to get things in place, and I feel as though the basic staff is there to do the job, but I understand,
right,
you know, capital and raises and things like that. But
okay.
Unfortunately, right, it's the labor thing is going to be the
yeah,
school and how right, good they are at.
Yeah. Well,
and the school gets more complicated because
right,
then it's not just their budget, but Chapter 70 and
right,
school
yeah,
choice kids coming in and out and charter school kids
right,
coming in and are going out. And
right,
the
so there's
unfunded mandates.
So you could yep, have the same number of employees and your budgets could right, still kind of go all over the
yep,
place.
And that gets back to my example last week. It may not have been understood, but an aircraft carrier, you know, it takes
mm-hmm,
so much to run it across the ocean. You put a few more people on it, a few less, doesn't change it much. And the school, with the diminishing population, you couldn't just immediately cut the school down. But
right,
if it does drop significantly, 10% population or something, then those numbers should start to kick in.
Right.
But when is a big question.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think we addressed it somewhat this year with adding the other grade and taking it away. I mean, not funding
right,
the school choice addition.
Right.
That was the first step, I think. And
right,
we definitely have been looking at a lot of this type of thing.
That was critical.
Closely.
Yeah. We were left that article on the charter schools there. I have attempted to read that two different times. Wow. Good Lord. That's so confusing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right, Kevin, thank you for swinging by. What can we do for you?
Well, I can actually kind of answer a little bit of what Ralph was just asking. Is it depends on what the level of service you're looking for. If you're looking for this continual level of service that we're providing at this point in time, then it's just basically going to be the cost of the small items that keep going up. You know, obviously your payroll is going to go up. Your benefit's going to go up. These parts are going to continue to grow regardless. You know, is fuel up a little bit? You know, is fuel down a little bit? You know, these are going to change up a little bit. But overall, and I think I can speak for, well, I know I can speak for the highway department. If we're going to be continuing looking for the same level of service as what we're providing now, then we should be okay. If they're going to be looking for more services, more stuff to be happening, then there's a possibility that you may be looking at, you know, can we absorb what's being asked of us, you know, or is it's just not going to work and you have to add another body. So I think kind of what I'm trying to get at is it depends on what the level of service is what the town is looking for from the highway department specifically.
Mm-hmm.
So if we stay the way we are, then I think, again, this is my own personal opinion. It's given me, this is my second year of putting the budget together. I think I've pretty much got things where we need to be. I think I've pretty much taken my line items and put them out. I'm still going to end up probably tweaking line items a little bit here and there. You know, maybe taking one, and because I hate 400. 400 is other, okay? And you can't track 400 unless you say, okay, I'm looking at this particular vendor. How much money did I spend on this particular vendor on other? How much did I do this on other? But these are all things you need to know. You need to be able to specifically look where you want to try and figure out where the money's gone to by who you spent the money with. Mm-hmm. Kind of make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's...
Yeah.
So I'm like I said, that's still going to be kind of a little mm-hmm, bit of a shell game to make sure, because once again, I don't like the idea of umbrelling everything under other or utilizing something because it's close to it. You know, you take a line item that hypothetically arbitrary number has a $10,000 budget in it, but $3,000 of that always goes to this particular act or materials. Then I feel to get a clearer picture of exactly where we're actually spending our money instead of just smoke and mirrors, I would prefer to roll that line item out, reduce it from the first, add it to the second, and then that way I know exactly where my money's going from,
mm-hmm,
which makes it, again, for me, the more broke down it is, I believe the better I can control how much money I'm spending.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's like, I'm like everybody else. You know, I've got a budget at home that I have to abide by,
mm-hmm,
you know, and if I know that, you know, this is how much money I've got for this particular thing, I know television, okay? You know, do I want the DVR, whatever, blah, blah, blah? Well, that's going to cost an additional so much money a month. That's going to be so much money a year. You know, is it really going to be worth it to me? So that's the way I look at my own finances. So that's why I'm trying to do the same thing with our finances here within the town, to be more clear, more precise, and
I think it's easier, and I think you're right on the head here with that, because I think it's easier for you to present the budget, and I think it's easier for the finance committee to understand it too.
Exactly.
Is there, right, you're not guessing about, well, you got this dollar amount and other, what's other, you know?
Right, it's, exactly. You know, I hate 400.
And with what you're describing, that would make it easier for everybody. There's question about it.
I'll be honest with you. The job you guys do, I wouldn't do. You know, to be honest with you.
Pays great.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure. You know, hey, double your salary.
We did. You just missed it.
Yeah, okay. You know, and I got a good, great respect for what you guys do, capital improvement, and all the other boards. I mean, because these are all things that people have volunteered their own personal time, take the time away from their wife, their kids, significant others, anything else that they may end up doing, and to provide a service to the town, I think is phenomenal. You know?
Thank you.
Right. I do realize, of course, my question is basically, do we have a more or less the size of staff we need in the different departments for what the town is for population? And I think that is about right. But I do understand, though, that sometimes you've got to spend money to save money, but you got to see the results. And that may be, as you know, as an example I gave a long time ago, we went from all hydraulic machines to all electric machines, a lot of money, but cut the cycle times dramatically and cut down all the operational costs.
Made you more efficient and effective.
It's just, we were way, way ahead. So those are investments the town might make from time to time. And of course, the board here is sick and tired of hearing me about preventative maintenance and maintenance and capital budgets. In my opinion, those should be all funded actual budgets with people and software and equipment to do it. That would be quite a cost. You can't do it overnight, but if there's a plan and you build into it, but yet you would, this town should never do it unless the payoff was there. And of course, I'm confident it would be, but so I don't throw that into growth of department. That's like an investment, you know, but I think that, again, answer myself, I just feel as though the departments are, you know, the staffing around here, everybody's pretty busy, but I think we have enough to do the job. And
so the main reason I came down, if that's okay, I was watching on TV, and a comment was made, I believe it was Bill that made it, when you and I had the quick discussion today, you know, we talked to the select board, and what we're going to do is we're going to go with the 130 for our funding, for the engineering, to make sure that we continue to march in the proper direction.
Right.
But because we don't, I, and again, it was something that you said on Tuesday that made the light go off in my head. I was very focused on what I was attempting to get done for our department to make sure that we were heading in the right direction. I don't want to say I had blinders on, but I think I was too focused on it. So after what you said, once again, the light bulb went off my head. You know what? This is something we still have to do. We still have to move forward with it. But it's not right to the entire town, besides just the people that are the ratepayers, which are the ones that are actually footing the bill on this. Right. But the information's not out. It's the 11th hour. It's not fair to anybody. You're trying to have people make snap decisions the whole nine yards. But again, the long and the short is the sky is still falling. We still have issues, which I really didn't appreciate. And I got 6 phone calls on that at the house, by the way. But what I'm attempting to do is making sure that the public is aware of exactly what's going on. I'm not trying to push this so far forward. I'm not trying to jam anything down anybody's throat.
Right.
But again, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make sure that the people understand what's going on. Give them a full time. And again, with this ad hoc committee, I think this is going to be a great thing.
Yep.
I did talk with Keith, our chief operator down there, And I said, you know, what I'd like to do is after the dust settles, you know, after town elections and the town meeting, the whole nine yards, what I'd like to see is I'd like to see the Board of Selectmen. I'd like to see the chair of the Finance Committee. And I'd like to see the chair of the Capital Improvement take a tour of the wastewater treatment plant. And at that point in time, and just so everybody's well aware, I'd like to have it videoed. So that way it's a tour. It's an educational tool at the same time. So that way mm-hmm. somebody can watch this and understand mm-hmm. once it goes from point A to point B, this is what it does. But this we don't have this right now. So this is what it does to this section over here. So it'll be almost like a physical walkthrough of exactly when it comes into the plant until it physically leaves the plant. And then we're going to also have to have a little side area or a side note of within this documentary, this is a poor choice of words, on the lab work. You know, these guys do 2 days worth of lab work. Mm-hmm. You know, these guys are there 365 days a year. Mm-hmm. Yep. Doesn't make a difference. It's Christmas, New Year's, their kid's birthday, their spouse's birthday, makes no difference whatsoever. There's somebody there every single solitary day, mm-hmm. weekends, holidays. It may only be 2 hours in Deerfield and 2 hours in South Deerfield, but they still have their samples that they have to take because the samples have to sit for so long before they can physically be gone through and done their lab work on them. And again, I'm not an expert exactly how the entire operations works. Every time I go down there, I try and pick Keith's brain a little bit more so that way I can learn a little bit more of exactly what he is. I'm not a chief operator by any means. Honestly, my goal is to do is I would like to be a certified operator at some point in time just so that way I can say, yeah, I'm a certified operator. I understand exactly how this is working. You know, can I do this right now? No. Can I do this maybe in the next 2 years? Yeah, I probably can. Mm-hmm. I mean, because it's not rocket science, but it is science.
Yeah, my concern is that we learned from the roof project. I understand we were chasing the grant.
But we
got ahead of the town.
Right.
And we just need to, you know, as we do 5-year and 10-year planning, mm-hmm. we should be able to say this is going to come down here in 18 months.
Correct.
And get to the point where we do that video and we invite right. the town in. And we get a lot more support at that point.
I understand that, you know, but, and I'll be honest with you, that's exactly the 99.9% of the reason is why I went to the select board, I went to Doug, and said, we need to pull this part of it mm-hmm. for right now. Because
this is beginning of what could be a huge project.
It all depends on what people want to do. But again, this is great because that's not going to be a decision that I'm going to make. It's not going to be a decision that the select board is going to make. You know, this committee is going to go through. They're going to look at it. They're going to see exactly what it is, take the pros, take the cons, put it together, and then make a recommendation. Mm-hmm. And run it forward from there. And that's going to take some time. But I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to be looking for an accelerated and not just, well, you know, we're going to look at this once a month for the next 3 months. Or the next year or the next 3 years. I'm looking for accelerated. As soon as this is officially formed, I want to know who the chair is going to be. I want to know who the scribe is going to be. And within 48 hours of the end of your meeting, of any of your meetings, myself and Doug, we would like to have minutes of those so that we know exactly where we're at and what's happening. Mm-hmm. So, once again, we need to move forward. We need to make sure something's going on. I don't want to shoehorn this into a short amount of time, but the other side of the coin is I was just talking with somebody at the pharmacy, okay? 20 years ago, they were talking about doing upgrades to the plant.
Before that.
We have reports from 17 years ago, 12 years ago, 8 years ago that we spent money on. We have those reports, and
we
hadn't moved forward with it.
We were at full capacity when the pickle plant was pushing.
Right.
I mean, that was our issue back then.
Right. Kevin's point, and this does happen, is, you know, the concern is that things just... You don't want to wait until it breaks.
Right.
That's so much more expensive.
And I don't think that's the intention whatsoever. And as far as the headwork projects and that obviously that's a priority.
Right.
I think most people that have been paying attention to this issue mm-hmm. realize that is a priority and that's something that's got to move along. People, right. This ad hoc committee cannot simply come in and now drag the feet.
Right. That's all I'm asking,
right,
just not the
and
dragon fee.
And they've got to move. And I think people understand that, at least for the Headworks project, as right. far as that's going to be a priority. There's no question about it. The good part is the $130,000 is placed, so we can search out possible grant monies along the way, too.
Exactly.
So there's that with that $130,000 as far as seed money, I think that is a good start for us.
And
it gets us moving in the right direction.
Correct.
And then I think with the ad hoc committee, I think there's enough people involved with that. And as we go along, hopefully more of the public will be aware that there are some priorities here that have to be dealt with fairly reasonable amount of time.
Right.
So, and that's what I'm hoping for.
I appreciate the fact that you have brought this to the forefront. Because I think that all of us on the committees, anybody to do with the town, have a responsibility to the public out there to make them aware of things. And with this sewer treatment plant and the lines and so forth, it's out of everybody's mind. No one's thinking about it. But it's a real thing. And we can't just arbitrarily decide someday, oh, we're not going to put any money for it. We have to, by law. Correct?
Correct. I mean,
we've got to. And so I think it really needs to be a public educational thing. And it is going to take some time, and that's where this committee can help get the word out. Because the worst thing in the world is to have it come up the town meeting someday that, oh, yeah, we need $30 million for a brand new plan. You know, but people can slowly start to see you're working in a progressive way to fix some things initially. But the bottom line of what I'm trying to say is it is imperative that we attempt to try to make the general public understand what's going on. And we're not alone. As I look around to all these other towns, they've got pretty much the same problem.
I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. You know, before I came to work for the town, you hit the lever, it leaves the bowl.
That's it.
Do you really care? Did you really know? Did I really know? Yeah, I knew basically where it went. Did I know all the processes that has to go through? No, certainly not. I mean, it's huge on what it takes to go ahead and take care of wastewater. But like I said, you know, before I came to work for the town, before I was involved in this, don't get me wrong, I never flushed flushables. I didn't put my dental floss down there. I never put underwear, socks, or T-shirts or anything like that. But the other side of the coin is, you know, I never thought about it. You know,
yeah. That's my
you know,
point.
And there's so many people that are out there that just don't know. So we do need to put forth an education plan.
Chris Collins and the community access people just did a thing for the town of Waitley, mm-hmm. and they did a whole interview thing with agricultural people.
Actually, I was just watching that.
They did a wonderful job with that, and it sounded like they were pretty excited about how well that went.
Yeah.
Maybe we use them to do educational videos on different aspects of running the town.
And I think that's phenomenal. You know, I know Jane Trezere, she went ahead and she applied for a grant, personal grant on her own, and what she's trying to do is she's trying to work with the kids at the schools through their arts programs. These are the different things, and basically it's going to, her original one is wrapped around wastewater. What you flush down the toilet, how the system works, whole nine yards. Because in the past, we have put out informational packets, flyers, or whatever, that have gone along with the sewer bills every single solitary year. And a comment that was made when I did make that comment in one of the meetings a while ago, they were like, well, I don't share my bill with my children. It's like, yeah, but there's a flyer that goes along with it. So now we're starting to think, well, let's try and reverse this. Let's educate the kids, and maybe the kids will help educate the parents. And now you're starting a new generation of informed people of exactly what it is. And if you can turn it into an art, especially for the kids, first off, they'll have fun with it. You know, they can make little documentaries with it. They can do their art projects with it. And if some of these things, we can go ahead and add some of this into the flyers that we send out with our wastewater bills. You know, I think it's a win-win, personally, myself. You know,
it's really
and again,
sad.
I really want to say thank you to Jane, because she is the one. She pushed forward. She went through all of the applications, the whole nine yards. she spent quite a few hours trying to make this happen for the town, you know, and once again, it's a benefit to the town. Once again, like you people do, you know, you volunteer your time, you do what you need to do, and she's doing the same exact thing. So it's, you know, my hat's off to the people that do all the volunteer work within the town. I mean, it's huge. Because we can't afford for somebody to be paid to be all the things that need to be done here in the town. There's just no way.
I was going to say that I think there's a tremendous lack of knowledge in the general public about how does a police department run and what does it do? Fire departments, what do they do? A lot of people think, well, you just drive the cruiser or you just take the fire truck and turn the hose on. And these things are very complex systems, and whether it's that or the sewer treatment or DPW, awful lot involved, and they have no clue as to what it does for them and what the costs are.
So that was all I had. Sorry, it's
no. Thanks for coming down.
I
join you in your commitment to this process and this project, and I don't take the pulling back, I guess, on this particular town warrant as any indication that this isn't a very serious project.
Correct.
It deserves a lot of attention. You know, we very much appreciated the presentation 3-4 months ago.
Right.
With the initial kind of thoughts about this, I know there's still some decisions about, you know, septage and this and that and exactly what, you know, kind of pieces we want in place. I think the committee's a great idea. I think the tour of the people that are going to be on the committee and on the chairs of these boards talking about it, I think is the single best thing you can do, because it's great for everyone wants to go and learn about it, but it's so easy, I know, even for myself, to just get, you're just looking at a piece of paper. And when you know what that room looks like or what those walls look like, mm-hmm. or what that vehicle looks like or whatever, it just makes it a lot more real and allows you to think about it more holistically. So.
You can't talk about cost and responsibility for the cost until you understand what the topic really is.
Certainly.
So,
I mean, because you can look at something that's written in front of you with a number that's attached to it, but if right. you don't understand everything that goes along with it, that makes it happen, then it's just words, letters, and numbers.
Yeah. Yep.
So, I mean, so that's and again, it was. I went down there to talk with Keith, you know, because I was trying to stop and check with Keith, you know, see how we're going, look at different things, you know, where we're at. And when we were in there talking, all of a sudden the light bulb went off my head. Well, how about if we do this? I mean, because he's an excellent speaker. Mm-hmm. You know, he's a very, very educated person, and he speaks extremely well, probably much better than I do. But I told him, I says, I don't want to use a proper improper terminology here by saying dumb it down, but I've been around it long enough that I understand what he's saying at this point in time. Mixed liquors, BODs, blah, 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 mm-hmm. blah. And if he starts throwing all those at you guys, your eyes are going to roll in the back of your head.
Right.
So you have to, if you go ahead and you take a BOD, you have to say, well, this is what it is. Right. And this is where it is within the process.
Right.
Because that's how I had to pull him back, too. Because when he was trying to, you know, because again, this is second nature to him. So it's like, and I'm trying to go, wait a minute, I only caught about a third of what you just said. Yeah. And then once he explained it to me, it absorbed, and then it was good to go. So,
okay.
And that's what I tried to explain to him. I said, you need to make sure that you teach to your audience is what you need to do.
Sounds like the charter school funding report.
Not sure how that went, but okay.
Well, and also just wanted to thank you overall. I think you do a great job managing the different facilities and taking on, you know, a lot of the things that the town could have done better jobs at being more proactive about are things that fall under your purview and you're trying to catch up with, whether it's trees or sewage treatment plants or building maintenance. So very much appreciate that, you know, you're having to be as dynamic as probably any department head in terms of what's being asked of you. And so really appreciate that.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. I'm just trying to do the best job I can for the town, you know, because it's my town too. My taxes.
All right, great.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
Thanks, Kevin.
Yep. Bill, you're not usually the one that gets people coming down here.
It's all your fault, Bill.
It wasn't even directed at him. Whole process we have.
Okay, I'm gonna pass these out.
What do we got here?
This is from Doug. I think I got one more to go with it. This is just breakdowns of numbers we've discussed before.
Yep.
So here's another one. This is on the special town meeting. This one's, I think, a little less informative, but just so you have everything. So going back to the general budget, I mean, the last thing that I kind of want to make sure we're all on the same page is, this budget detail, the large legal, this shows every difference of our recommendations, which are summed up on the page that I gave, I put together.
Mm-hmm.
And so obviously, one of the important functions of the meeting that we're going to be providing is on the ones where we recommended something different to be able to articulate why. And, obviously we may not all be of the same opinion, that may not have been a unanimous vote on a particular item, but, just that, we are all prepared, have thought about and prepared, have called upon to discuss those topics as much as any of them. So just kind of going through the list, of the differences we have here. Just to recap, we had a difference on the accountant's salary. Looking through general government, I think that was the only general government difference. We had the difference on the police payroll with the resource officer. We had, let's see, so that's that one. Let me just circle these.
So did you get any more feedback on that one?
On which one?
The police officer one. I thought they were talking or...
I don't know. I believe there may be additional information. I don't want to speak to it because I wasn't a part of the conversations, but I think that it's going to be a great forum for the different parties to stand up, see where we are at that point, and then everybody make an informed decision.
Okay.
So let's see. Then we had a small difference on the elementary school, 8,900. We had the $4,000 difference on highway expense. Mm-hmm. We had a $700 difference on the library, a little over $3,000 difference on the summer swim program, a small difference, $800 on the Tri-Town Beach. And I think that is it. Oh, and then the Warren articles, there's some there as well. We had differences on the OPEB funding, Montague Legal Defense, and Mosquito Control.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a difference on the capital request, but again, that's really more the CIPC. We're adhering to the recommendation, the difference there with those other two sections of the Senior Center flooring.
Yeah.
So, not that we need to go through all those again, but just wanted to point them out, make sure you had this list, so we're all just kind of aware of the results of our efforts. And obviously, the total difference of our budget as passed versus requested was $117,000. As often is the case, the truth is sometimes somewhere in the middle. So some of these may go with our number or not our number. So we'll see where we end up.
Right.
But yeah. I think we did a good job. And on top of the difference in our budget, and that isn't a goal or a point of what we're doing, but there's a number of other budgets that the requests were revised. So, if you actually went back and looked at where we started to now, it's a pretty substantial difference. And again, there's no number or goal of how much. We're not just the hatchet guy trying to cut things down. But I think we did a pretty good job this year of using a consistent approach across all the budgets as much as we could.
I think if you go back to the basic charter of a finance committee and what we're about, we are really there, of course, as a representative of the residents, but we're reviewing these departments. We're looking for the logic or illogicness of things. We're looking for errors, certainly to make recommendations. The voter still gets to say at the end what they want, but I think a lot of reliance goes on the Finance Committee as to whether we feel as though it's in line. And,
mm-hmm. Yeah, because the majority of the differences of our budgets relate to new services, the expanded hours in the inspections office and the new police officer, and then kind of very particular warrant articles of OPEB and Mosquito and Montague Legal Defense. So, there are other smaller differences, but big picture, those are kind of the two things that we do differently than the budgets as requested for a variety of reasons. And, we can talk about that at town meeting and hopefully the voters, people watching, these meetings throughout the year, and the voters at town meeting will feel prepared for the decisions we're faced with.
The thing is that we don't have the authority to change anything. All we can do is review and recommend. We can't make a change.
We're just...
I think that's sometimes understood as our job is to change these numbers, and we can't.
We can recommend. Okay. I don't know what that means, really, because, I mean, our job is to recommend numbers.
That's...
Right.
Well, let me try differently.
Sure.
That's what I mean, is that, that's what I said earlier, is we can recommend, but we have no authority to go to a department manager and say, you will cut your budget by $400,000. We do not have the authority to do that. It's the town voter that is the ultimate decision maker.
Right, and I don't think that we've tried to do that.
We haven't.
Okay.
I am attempting on the public record to explain that the Finance Committee is here to review and make recommendations, but the Finance Committee does not have the authority to make any cuts. We can recommend, but we cannot make the cuts. Is that correct or not?
It is. I guess so.
Okay.
It seems like a solution to a problem we don't have, but that's fine. It's been noted.
Did we?
That's. I only say it because I don't believe that's true. I think there's a lot of people believe that we are the ultimate decision maker on whether something is decided at this amount or not.
I mean, you know, it's only, look, there's two numbers that go to town meeting. There is the requested budget mm-hmm. amounts, which are the mm-hmm. result of the conversations mm-hmm. between the department heads mm-hmm. with the Board of Selectmen in conjunction with the mm-hmm. town administrator. Separately, there is the recommended amount that mm-hmm. comes from the Finance mm-hmm. Committee, which mm-hmm. ostensibly could be done completely in isolation without any input or conversation with any of the other mm-hmm. groups. I think it's helpful to have some high-level coordination between the Finance Committee and the Board of Selectmen
yep.
with the two meetings we had, one at the beginning of the budget season and one mm-hmm. kind of most of the way through, to make sure we're on the same page with the high-level items. And I also think it makes sense to have, you know, different departments come in and talk to us, especially about the more complicated budgets mm-hmm. that have more moving parts. So I think that, you know, to your point, I think we agree that I think we've done a good job of minding those parameters and still being collaborative with the other people. I do think that we could try to be more efficient next year. I understand it's certainly a large use of not only our time, but all the department heads' time and the town administrator's time and Jonathan's time, who has to film all this stuff, and people watching it at home. If there's ways that we could streamline this process more, I think what we've always tried to do this year is the budgets that are put together and consistent, and there's a narrative and there's a theme, and we don't need to keep going. That's mm-hmm. all we're looking for. You know, like the CPA tonight, we don't need to have somebody come in and read us all the back and forth of how they got there. You know, that's that committee's job, like that's the Capital Committee's job, and we took their recommendations as well. So I agree with you that there's important distinctions between the roles of the different boards and committees, and it often can get a little bit gray in terms of who can actually do what. Mm-hmm. But I think that it works best and worked better this year, in part because we all worked together and kind of mm-hmm. helped each other out. So that was great. Yeah.
I don't disagree with one thing you said. You gave a long explanation, but I think the point I'm making is perhaps too basic and too simple. I'm trying to say that I believe out in the public, there are people that believe if we said to Kevin, you cannot buy that truck, then that would be the rule. And I'm merely saying that's not true. And that's all I was trying to say. And you may feel that everybody knows that, but I can honestly tell you, I don't believe that's the case.
Okay.
Noted. Well, the ultimate say, obviously, is the town floor.
Exactly.
The voters.
And that's what I said earlier.
The voters are going to determine.
It's always the voter. But.
Right. All right. What is any other comments or thoughts on overview of the budget, areas of the budget? Anything else we want to talk about before we adjourn and the next get together at town meeting?
The certification, the assessor certification.
Yep.
I don't know where it is here, but did we talk about getting that so that a third of it came out budget year? Remember how it was lumpy at one point?
I think for some time now we've been doing a third of it per year.
Okay.
There was some conversation that over the course of time, and I don't know when or how, enough had built up that there was some excess in the account. I don't know, I wasn't able to confirm exactly how much, other than it seemed that with the $20,000 that was appropriated, or I'm sorry, was recommended this year, that that would be sufficient for the recertification that we'll be going through in FY17. There also may be some changes to the recertification process. It may
scale of years.
May go to every 5 years. Either, I don't know if that'll be an option or just what happens, but all that would be our next cycle. Either way, this is, you know, coming up, and we should have the money in there for it.
Looks good.
Anything else?
I don't have anything.
All right. Well, then I guess the next time we'll see each other is, if not on the street near randomly, be next Monday for town meeting. And thank you guys very much for all the work.
Well, thank
the
you.
Season.
No,
and,
thank
and
you.
And to Skip and John, who weren't here tonight, and to Doug as well, because, you know, it is a big effort. And I think we've made some progress and hopefully continue to.
Good job.
All right. Anyone want to make a motion to adjourn?
I'll make the motion to adjourn.
I'll second that.
Thanks. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
You didn't say
good job.
We have another schedule.